Let me show you something.
Hi there, welcome back to Culture Clash Reactions. My name is Fen.
My name's Akasha.
Sorry for the delay, guys. I know it's been a couple of weeks since our last video, but just work, mate. Just fucking work. I know everyone knows that feeling out there. Just work.
Yeah.
So we got a day off. I was like, right, let's do some recording. Anyway, we're back with sticking on the same theme on the British comedy slash panel show slash just British ridiculousness, really. Joe Wilkinson, I feel like you might recognize him when you see his face, because again, you've kind of seen me watch TV shows in the house and you would have seen him. 8 out of 10 cats does Countdown, do you remember what that is? Mm-hmm. Now we have a bit of an American audience watching this as well, like our American audience is growing, so I feel like I should just quickly run over that. That's Countdown is the old people show that's all about like words and numbers, and it's all like a bunch of like geniuses who can like make words and numbers out of nothing. And then 8 out of 10 cats was a comedy panel show just fucking riffing on like the week's
like news and stuff.
News, right? And stuff. They put the two together and made this ridiculous show that somehow works.
Yeah.
Joe Wilkinson. Who is Joe Wilkinson? Comedian. Not like one of my absolute favorites, but he does add a lot to the show. Sometimes he's a guest on the show, like he's on the panel, and sometimes they used to just have these like random, like almost like halftime Joe Wilkinson ridiculousness, because he's super British, super dry, super random. That's what I always found most funny about him, was just how random he was. But also, he kind of looks homeless. Like, he looks like he should be on some kind of, like, list. Do you know what I mean? Like, just looking at him, he doesn't look right. Something's off. So that adds to it. And he always wears this, like, shitty brown, like, diarrhea-colored suit.
Ew.
Like, that's, like, his whole kind of, like, gimmick.
Okay.
But he's also, I gotta give him props, he's very funny.
Okay.
But it's more the dry randomness is what makes him funny. And he plays, like, almost like a miserable... He plays, like, a homeless miserable... I think I'm getting that. Am I getting the point?
I think so, yeah.
Should we get into the video and watch him in action?
Yes.
This is this is Joe Wilkinson, Best Bits, 8 out of 10 cats does Countdown.
Right.
Let's do it.
6, 2, 5, 75, 50.
Oh,
and the target, 961.
Oh, give up.
Oh. Joe.
Did I describe him right, by the way?
Yeah.
Doesn't he look like somebody on some kind of list of
some
kind?
Or like what homeless or something.
9, 5, 6.
Okay, so how did you do it?
5 times 2.
5 times 2, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, no, that's bloody wrong already. Oh, no, 10. That's 10. 10.
Oh, Jesus. Come on, Joe, we need this.
I jumped ahead a bit.
John's not here, and I'm fucking losing again.
And then I did... this is bad even for me. Then I did times 50, which I then just jumped to that being 1,000, which is not.
My mouth.
Then I added a 50 and a 6.
556.
That's absolute dog shit.
This is what I mean by the halftime, just random
just
bits.
Random
just
stuff.
Random. He would just come on the stage and I don't know what the fuck's going on here, but... oh, actually, I do remember this. This is good.
Fuck off.
Joe, why have you got a bear with you?
Kind of hoping you wouldn't notice that. Well, we met on the train up here. Got chatting. He's escaped from the circus or something. And he's a big fan of the show, so he just sort of followed me here.
Well, that's nice.
No, he likes the proper show. He hates all this fucking shit.
Right. So what happened? Why are your clothes all ripped to shreds?
Well, we had a few cans on the way up here. And, you know how bears get when they're pissed up.
That does kind of look a real bear.
Taking a bite out of his chicken and mushroom slice. He went fucking mental.
Joe, how many you got?
5.
Sean?
6.
Jimmy?
You've got a 6. OK, what's your 5?
Pints.
Pints. Of course it is.
There's an O there, Joe.
Oh, cock and balls.
It could have been points.
Sean?
Depots.
Depots.
Oh.
As in,
is that an E?
That's the E.
Oh.
Because he got it wrong, he gets the points.
Yeah. So, Sean, talk me through how you're feeling at the moment.
Yeah, I'm processing it.
It feels to me like you were so confident, you had it all, and then that beat you.
That?
Yeah. Keep your own, love. I've got pints.
Well, it's a fairy tale story for you, Joe.
Should we go home?
Well, incredibly, I never thought I'd say it. 5 points to Joe! It's a card from Joe Wilkinson. I'm pretty sure it's from Joe.
up yours.
Dear Jimmy, I have a new job now, so you can stick countdown up your arse. NASA have sent me to a new planet as part of an intergalactic exchange program, and in return, they have sent an alien in my place, so he's going to be on the show instead of me. If you have a problem with that, tough shit. Joe Wilkinson. Right, so I guess please welcome the alien we've swapped for Joe Wilkinson.
All right.
So you're an alien from another planet, are you?
Yep, got a problem with that.
Just you look a lot like Joe Wilkinson.
Yeah, I've heard that. Yeah, I've heard we look pretty similar. Main difference is on our planet, we wear berets. Oh, and yeah, we've got boobs.
I've heard, by the way, on some podcasts that he actually comes up with a lot of these on his
really
own,
on
like
his
the
own.
Gimmicks and like the spaceship and just the right, and they go, yeah, they just build it for him.
That's funny.
It's
they look real.
They do look real. What the fuck? I've never seen this.
So Sean and Kevin have 36. Joe and Victoria have 46.
Yes. Ooh.
That means this is a crucial countdown conundrum. If you get this, you can draw.
Oh.
All right, fingers on buzzers. Your time starts now.
Can you get a word from that jumbled up letters? It's always pretty hard.
That's the stale.
That's the countdown conundrum. That's the bit at the end for the max points.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know.
Penis tail.
That's all I can see now is penis tail.
I know.
Go on, Joe.
That's not right.
Why did you make me press it then?
Sorry.
Okay, let's restart the clock. False alarm.
No idea.
I mean, the word stale is in there.
Yeah, but it's not that, though.
That makes one big word?
It's all jumbled up. The letters are jumbled up.
I know, but I'm saying, does that make one big word?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh.
Sean.
I think I got it.
Sean? Oh.
Please don't get it.
Well, I was going to say this word, which I think you'll find.
I'm going to restart the clock. Now, you're going to have
He's
to press the button pretty much immediately. Okay, restarting the clock now.
Oh!
Run out of time.
Joe, I will allow it. What is the word?
No.
What? I haven't heard a gong, Sean. I haven't heard a gong. Joe, what's the word? Quick.
I thought. No, I got it wrong.
Oh, sakes.
I thought it might be panelist, but there's loads of E's.
No, this is going to have to go to penalties.
This is really difficult. I
thought it was planus, but there's too many E's in that as
they
well.
Still don't have it. I said the word and they still don't have it. That's the level. That's the level we're playing at here. You say the word and they still go, well, I don't know.
I don't hear it.
Is it penalties, Jimmy?
Penalties.
Is there any way you could edit it so I do that and then you ask me and then I say, is it penalties?
Sure. Joe, what is it?
Penalties.
Shit. I think he's recognised Rachel off the proper show. He'll probably sniff her, see if he likes her. If he likes her, she's fine. If he doesn't, he'll rip her fucking head off. So this could make quite weird telly. How you getting on, Len? Oh, he's offering you a can. He likes her.
Thank
fine.
You. Just the one.
Hey, I wouldn't take all three.
No.
Can he show you a card trick he learnt at the circus?
Sure.
Pick a card, but don't show Len.
Okay.
Have a look, but don't show Len. Pat,
should
buckle.
I show the audience?
Get out of it. No, just put it. Do you remember it? Put it back in. Put it back in anywhere you like.
Okay.
Here we go. You like this, Rachel?
Okay.
You got them? I'll wake up. Here we go. Go on, then! Go on, then! Here we go. Go on. All right, mate, don't do it.
Why is that funny?
Absolute prick. Is that your card?
That one?
Yeah.
No.
Of course it's not your card! He's a pissed-up bear! Jesus Christ, he had eight Cinzanos on the way here! Look, he hasn't shot himself! Fucking hell. Nice one, Rachel. All right, Timmy.
What are you wearing, mate?
Well, you mean my new trainers? Yeah, nice, aren't they? But, from Georgia Asda.
No, I mean the rest of it.
Oh, right, yeah. Well, you know I'm banging to me fashion. And so I've bought out my own fashion range. I make all my outfits out of things I find in and around my house. You probably can't tell, but this waistcoat is actually made out of my front and back door. The only downside is my house is being broken into a hell of a lot more.
Is it a good idea to put a grizzly bear in Dictionary Corner?
I'm gonna take that away.
Look at the ears moving.
Right.
You gonna be all right? Do you want to finish your model? He's in the middle of making a little rocking chair out of old pegs. Do you want to finish that? There you go. That should keep him entertained. It should be all right. Do you want another can? Yeah, all right, there you go. Actually,
what
no,
is even going on right now?
The best part is the actual show, the 8 out of 10 countdown, as I say, is designed for, like, you know, it's mainly people last time got mad and I said designed for old people, but it is. I mean, it's one of those that you just, it's kind of like Jeopardy over here, but, you know, it's for more, like, smarter people who like numbers and words. A lot of people who are kind of older didn't realize what was going on when this turned up at, like, 9 o'clock at night. They're like, oh, they're doing, like, late-night countdowns now. Like, there was a lot of complaints because all of a sudden there's a pissed-up bear on the fucking stage smashing the place to pieces. So, but, yeah, it is just random. It's got nothing to do with the game either.
Yeah.
What have we made that out of? The weakest bear I've ever seen.
I'm a bit annoyed I lost the fight now. my poem's about something very important to me. It's about how come...
I actually remember this. This is quite legendary on the show. He's wrote a poem.
Okay.
It's okay to name you Willie, but it's not okay to name the fellas Willie next to you at the urinals. So my poem's called Hanging About in a Train Station Toilet Naming People's Penises. Hello, commuter, on your way to work. I'm going to call yours Captain Birdseye.
I love seeing Sean Locke.
Because it looks like it's wearing a polo neck and winking at me. You're welcome. I just named your penis. Hello, train driver who's just nipped in for a piss. I'm going to call yours Mrs. Fernsby. My old geography teacher. Because you're small and wrinkly and have a birthmark down the side of your shaft. You're welcome. I just named your penis. Hello, please. Hello,
please. Please stop.
Hello. Hello, police officer. Police officer who's just been sent to the toilets because they've had reports of someone named. You can't arrest me for naming strangers. Oh, you can. I didn't know that. Oh, great. Now I'm electronically tagged again.
There you have it. Oh, right, Joe Wilkinson. Joe Wilkinson.
It's okay.
Thoughts?
I mean...
too dry, too British,
no,
too...
No, so I don't like when you say that. Because
okay,
I do like dry and British.
Sure.
But to me, I think that would have been funnier if we would have watched it in context
with the
show.
Context of the show.
But to me, it was just too many little random bits.
Interesting.
To really think... Like, the bear to me, like, okay, yeah, it was funny, but it's nothing that I would have, like...
Do you know what I'm even thinking?
Because I've seen him in other things. Like, we watched, what was Ricky Gervais's show?
Afterlife.
Afterlife. And he was the mailman.
Yes, he was. Yes, that's right.
And he was super dry. And, like, and even
when
I've seen him on that show before. But I honestly, it's not going to be a popular opinion. I don't think that was a good.
No, that's, that's what you hear.
I don't think that was just a good put together video. Like, I think there are way funnier moments.
Here's the thing. I don't know if I can defend it because like the bear thing. I think it was, there is no context. I actually think there is no context. It just used to be like a halftime thing. Hey, everyone, Joe's here. And he just,
yeah.
But I think that's what we Brits like as well. Like, we like the completely not really in context, random. There's a fucking drunk bear.
Course.
He's covered in,
yeah.
You know.
Yeah, well, that's what I'm
it's
saying.
It's all just like silly
I
fun.
I think that would be funny and silly if we were watching it in the show where you're doing like the questions and they're, you know, making jokes and then that just shows up out of nowhere.
Right.
But I think knowing it was going to be random bits and it was just 15 minutes
maybe.
Of just weird stuff,
okay.
It's not as funny.
What do you think of the poem?
I mean, the poem was funny. The
poem was good.
Yeah. And I like that show because they're all funny people. So
sure.
A lot of the things that make it funny
is that
it's just that they're just playing off each other.
Right. So it's not something that I would like specifically tune in for or something like that. You know what I mean? It's mm-hmm. like it's just easy watching TV while
having
dinner or whatever. It's just a bit of fun. But I know exactly what you're saying.
Do you know what I'm saying?
We've seen funnier stuff.
Yeah.
Obviously.
Yeah.
And then the other thing I was going to say, not to bring the mood down, but like seeing Sean Locke like laughing is actually quite sad now that he's passed away.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know, like he, because Sean was so well respected within the comedians,
mm-hmm.
you know, circle that whenever anyone
and
made
him laugh.
And he
was like a staple on that show as well.
Yeah,
right?
He was. And so whenever anyone made him laugh in particular, it felt like an extra point, you know what I mean? Because
mm-hmm.
he was the comedian's comedian.
Yeah.
But anyway, rest in peace, Sean and Locke. But yeah. Any final thoughts? I like your input. That was good. It's kind of, I agreed with a lot of it.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, it was,
it's
just
not
a lot
me
of requests.
Being like, you
no,
know,
no, not at all. I know what you mean.
I think I would like to, even if it's not on the channel, I would like to watch another one.
Sure.
Because I think that was just a bad choice of clips to put together.
Maybe. I mean, that's some of the best bits. It is called Best Bits, so I don't know. But anyway, I know what you're saying.
You know what I mean?
What you're saying. Anyway, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.
Check us at Instagram, Culture Clash Reactions.
Always a pleasure
and
hanging out.
And check out, I can't believe you didn't even mention my little Christmas setup.
Yes, somebody please in the comments just say, oh, you have a nice, cute little Christmas.
I think you guys
Christmas.
Know me well enough
Good
now.
Point, actually. I didn't actually say Merry Christmas to everybody.
Yeah.
That's what I forgot to say at the beginning of the video. Anyway, never mind. Yeah. My bad.
But, yeah. Okay.
Thanks for watching. See you next time.